All right, hang on to your Spidey suit, folks. In the last episode of Spider-Man 2, we witnessed a real roller coaster. Harry, in a fit of, let's call it, creativity, turned MJ into a wild symbiote beast. Scream went on a four-round rampage, giving Peter a run for his money and a lot to think about in couples therapy. Then, in a shocking turn of events, Peter gets hit with a symbiote seizure during a showdown with Venom's slimy plague. To save the day, Mr. Negative and Spider-Man Robin dive into Peter's noggin to unravel the gooey mystery. Mr. Negative, in a last-ditch move, hands over all his power to tackle the source of the problem. And boom, not only does this rescue Peter, but it also scores him a snazzy new anti-venom power suit. Fashion forward, if you ask me. Now our trio, MJ, Peter, and Miles, cook up a scheme to swipe Venom's precious meteorite rock. Why? Because it's the key to transforming the Big Apple into a symbiotic circus. Get ready for the ultimate face-off, the three Spider Stooges versus the intergalactic goon Venom. It's showdown time, baby.
All right, phase one done, let's go.
You want to join us? We know it.
All right, here we go.
Anti-venom's gonna sting, Harry!
Come on.
stronger than the symbiote, Harry! Fight it! The symbiote's using you! It doesn't care about anything but itself! Or these guys? Brute force isn't working! Gotta be a better way! Gonna heal the world with you! Not like this!
The meteorite. You took it from us!
This man's growing wings, bro. What the fuck? Bro! So we got two phases of standard Venom, so we're probably gonna get two or three phases with the winged Venom.
I think the goo aliens are mad we took their stuff.
Yeah, well, they started it.
I think we are going to have to fight him with Miles here. Game of the year, bro. I can't say no, bro. This has been a really good surprise.
Okay, right?
I did not expect the game to be this good.
Let's just get him out of here.
I heard people saying the story wasn't good, but in my opinion, the story is excellent. It's great, bro. If I'm being honest. Alright, winged Venom. I don't know, Miles, I guess. We'll see how this goes. Ooh. Alright, let's see.
Oh.
is his dream, too.
Sorry, Harry. Heard enough about this nightmare. I'm waking you up. I'll do whatever it takes to get you away from that thing.
Oh, wow.
He has us now.
Damn. Oh, jeez. Phase two. Let's see what this holds. This should be interesting.
Just hang on, buddy! Please, no. Leave him alone.
Either way, Pete.
We still have time?
No, we don't. It'll kill them. And then it'll kill you. Let's heal the world, Pete. Together.
Ah!
I'm sorry.
Give me some room. I don't know if it's gonna work, but I gotta try.
Pulse is weak. We gotta move.
What have you done? What have you done to him?
I'm so sorry.
I'm coming with you. Wait.
There are traces of brain activity, but his chances of coming back are very slim.
Just keep him alive. Get the G serum ready. ASAP.
For the last few years, tragedy has tried to tear the city apart. But we somehow kept going. We battled sickness, evil, cataclysm. We are tired, anxious, stressed, numb. But we have never lost hope. The city needs to heal. We're all ready to return to normal, but what is normal? What if it no longer exists? Over the last half hour, I've talked about how these events have changed me. But what about you? In this ongoing series, I will be talking with people throughout the city, exploring our new behaviors, new routines, new thoughts and feelings, I hope you'll join me on this journey. This has been Mary Jane Watson, and you're listening to The New Normal.
Ooh, she's got her own podcast.
Episode one, done.
Nice.
I don't know.
Ooh, are these good to go?
In a minute, I want to show you something first.
Okay.
It has molasses in it.
Yum, I'll take those.
Thanks again for the donation, Peter. Have you talked to Miles about?
Not yet.
You ready?
Miles. I've been meaning to talk to you about something. I mean, I have been talking to you all the time. It's great to talk. So many good talks. I just haven't been talking to you about what I should have been talking to you about.
Pete.
Let me start again.
I got this. All of it. Go be Peter Parker for a while.
Are you sure? It's a big city.
I can handle it. As long as I can still call you for advice.
You don't need it.
Maybe not now, but there'll come a time.
I'm here for you. Always.
Hey, bro. See you.
The original Spider-Man has retired at 25 years old, man. Yeah, that's until something happens to MJ. You can't retire, dude. What are you talking about? Retirement. What the hell?
What do you want?
The Spider-Men. You know who they are, don't you?
Why?
They ruined my son.
Oh my God, bro. Can you believe this, man? Yo, this man is such a... Bro, I'm so pissed off. They ruined your son, man.
We all have to experience loss. Even you, Norman.
What are you writing?
Otto still looks pretty good, though. It looks, I don't know, I don't want to say he looks younger, but...
The final chapter.
Hi. I hope you're hungry. Food's almost ready. Why don't you go show her your essay? He worked so hard on it.
Some guy in Harlem, probably seen him volunteering in the city, helping out his city council mom, and trying to live up to his hero dad. Yeah.
Miles' first kiss. Well, that was awkward.
Hey. Hi. Miles, Haley.
Bro, who is this guy, bro?
Albert.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
Oh, okay.
This is my daughter, Cindy.
Cindy? Why didn't we see her face? Who's Cindy? Anyway, guys, that'll wrap it up for the main story missions. The last episode will be dedicated to some of the side missions we started throughout the series. As usual, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.